I always love how they wrap this stuff, because I already have the expansion tank and fan shroud, and I also do the electric fan conversion. Alright. Here's the Behr radiator, which failed. And this is why I hate these things. You have all this plastic end tanks, which are pretty small to begin with, but you can see right here, this is all JB weld. The crack started from the neck and then started working its way down the side where the end tank meets the core. And you can actually see this blue shit coming out. That's all coolant. Had about 18,000 miles on it when it failed, which is outside of the warranty period. So it's only a 12,000 mile warranty. The Zionsville unit, which is, well, four times the price basically, has a lifetime warranty. Aluminum end tanks. You can see all the welding. It's pretty mint. You can also see how much beefier it is overall compared to that, which is real flimsy. And I'm going to be installing this today, along with my Zionsville radiator fan shroud and aluminum expansion tank. Did the electric fan conversion. I'll kind of go into that later on about what I did, but that's what the car looks like with nothing in it, so have some work to do. All right, I'm gonna start sliding the radiator in. It's kind of a tight fit, so take your time. So it seems like it wants to go. I just have to clear this side, and then I have to put the rubber stops on these little perches down here. All right, that is the radiator in. It was kind of a tight squeeze, but I, from my understanding, it's a little bit larger than the standard radiator, which is fine. Next thing I have to do is these original radiator supports. Put those in, and these are the original rubber grommets that go in. Just push those into place, and these will fit snugly over. All right, the next thing I'm going to do is drop the fan shroud and expansion tank in. As you see, I have an electric fan. I did the conversion on this car. Definitely well worth doing. That's the fan shroud in. Kind of the one we're working with. Some of the plumbing is hooked back up, so a lower radiator hose is attached to the lower radiator. I have to do the upper radiator hose and all the return lines from the heater core, which attach to the expansion tank. Just want to go over one quick thing with the newer style BMW radiator hoses. You don't have a hose clamp. You basically have that clip which inserts into a notch on a corresponding part. So this is the thermostat, and this is the upper radiator neck. All you have to do is just basically slide this on, and once it's in place, you close the pin, and that secures it in place. Then we'll do the same over here. Just gonna slide it on, drop the pin, and it's now secure.